Hey, comic book fans, your pal David here to give you guys some more comic reviews. Well, first off, I want to say that this is going to be a pretty negative video. Not intentional. When I go to the comic book store and I divvy up my comics, say this is what I'm going to do for one video, and that this whole thing wasn't intentional. I expected a couple of these books to be really good and one to not be really good. Well, first up is Stormwatch issue number 10. Out of the whole Wildstorm characters that come into the DC universe, Stormwatch has been one of my favorite ones. This issue was pretty interesting, and had a couple of really good parts. The storyline is that some archaeologists dig up this artifact, which is this old Stormwatch artifact. And the Stormwatch people notice that it gets activated, so they go down to recover it. And then once the artifact was activated, a big old monster happened, they fought it. It was a pretty cool fight. And then there were some other cool things. Before the artifact was opened up and all hell broke loose, all the Stormwatch people were checking out all the superhumans, all the metahumans, and the on Earth. And it was just so cool because you just see them, they're like, what the hell's going on? What's up with this all breakout of all these metahumans? So I think that all is really, really cool. The bad, the art was a little bit off at some points. There was some characters that I just looked at and I was just like, oh, you're not right as I've seen you before. But all in all, it was a pretty good issue. Nothing miraculous, but just a pretty good issue. I'm going to be giving Stormwatch issue number 10 just a 3 out of 5. Another decent book from the Stormwatch. Now, I read this book and I just wanted to wash my mouth out. It was just so terrible. And the only reason why I picked it up was because I wanted to give it a second chance. And that is Green Arrow issue number 10. I have had mixed reviews about Green Arrow, especially since the new relaunch. New relaunch has been just horrendous for Green Arrow. I'm hoping that Kevin Smith, if Kevin Smith is watching, which I know he's not, but if he is, I want you back on this book. Please, I'll give you a dollar. The storyline is that some robots are being mistreated and Green Arrow has to go and stop it. And it's just as bad as I explained it. It was just so you're not going to remember anything about this comic. I just, after reading just a couple pages, I was just like, if I didn't have this video review stuff, I would have just thrown this thing away and just said, no, I'm done. I don't want to read this crap. This is just shitty writing, shitty artwork. There's even a part where Green Arrow, he saves some girl, and the girl, or he says in the bubbles that, you know, hey, don't hit me, and you see the girl, but she's not hitting him. But it was just really bad artwork. Just everything about this book was just so horrendous. And on my Twitter account, I said something like, this stuff right here makes the stuff that Rob Liefeld's doing look like works of art. And if you guys didn't know, I really don't like Rob Liefeld, even though he is a good guy. I see his Twitter account. It just seems like a really good guy. Just doesn't go do comics like how I like him. I wasn't in the comics in the 90s, you know, so. But I'm going to give Green Arrow issue number 10 half a star out of 5. It was just horrendous, horrendous. I'm not even going to give this book a third chance. I wish that this book would be canceled, not JLI. So, if DC, if you're listening, cancel this book and save JLI. And now, another book, which I'm probably going to be dropping, and that is Superman Action Comics issue number 10. Grant Morris, I know he's mixed baggage. You know, he could be great, he could be just go into left field and just be like, okay, I don't know where he's going, but okay. And this storyline is that there's basically this guy like Kraven the Hunter coming after Superman because, just like Kraven the Hunter when he was hunting Spider-Man, he wants to kill everything and he hasn't killed an alien, so he's gonna go kill Superman. Yeah, there's even a point in there where Superman goes and tries to figure out why this guy's after him, and he goes, breaks into this one house, and he tells the guy, you know, why is this guy hunting me, blah blah blah. And then he tells the guy, run away, you know, don't ever come back. And the guy was like, what about my hamsters? And so what does Superman do? He takes the hamsters to the Justice League and tells them, what should I do with these hamsters? Can you take the hamsters off my hands? Right when I was reading that, I was like, what the fuck am I reading? This is just terrible, terrible shit. And then, one of the things that is totally left field for Superman, he goes and starts talking about world hunger in certain areas and how he wants to change it, how the Justice League should go and change all that. That is totally against Superman's code. Superman has been known to go and fight aliens and all this stereotype stuff, but he doesn't get into the politics or anything like that in the world. There was a part where World War III happened and he didn't have no part of it. There's just... And even there was stuff in the 9/11 when that stuff happened, and DC did some comics about it, and Superman, he was just there to help pick up the stuff, but he wasn't there to fix the whole entire problem. It just totally went against everything about Superman in this comic. And it hurts. This comic is just terrible. I'm sorry if I'm going on a rant, but I just did not feel the love for this comic. I did not feel that love for Grant Morris. And it makes me really off-put about the stuff that Grant Morris is doing. Even though I did like what he did in Batman Incorporated, this stuff is just not for me. And I don't know if I'm going to be picking up the next issue, but this just issue right here of Action Comics is going to get a 1 out of 5. I just did not like it whatsoever, and I never thought I would say that about Action Comics. I thought I'd always pick it up just because it's action. Just like how I would always pick up Batman just because it's Batman. But this one, I don't know. I'm on the hinges about just dropping this whole entire book and just waiting for Grant Morris to be off of it and then picking it back up. Well, my name's David. If you like reviews like these, I got a bunch more on my page. And I got topics like DC Comics putting out 0 issues in September. You know what to do. Subscribe up top, like on the bottom. My name's David. Thank you for watching.